Audience, you may sit.
You didn't say Simon Says.
Audience, rise again. Audience, sit down again.
Okay. If everyone would please take your seats, we're about to start the video of Alexander's scouting career.
Place rose. I hear her voice in the morning hour. She calls me. The radio reminds me of my home far away. Driving down the road, I get a feeling that I should have been home yesterday. Yesterday.
Well, good morning, everyone. I'm Mark Lambert, the Chartered Organization Representative for Troop 309. Welcome to the Eagle Court of Honor for Alexander Abraham, and thank you, Alex, for the honor to participate. On behalf of Troop 309, I call this Court of Honor to order. I would like to invite Mason Terry, Senior Patrol Leader of Troop 309, for the presentation of the colors.
Audience, please rise. Scout, attention. Color guard, advance. Scout, salute. Color guard, halt. Color guard, cross the colors. Post the colors. Please join me in reciting the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Two, color guard reform. Color guard dismissed. Scouts, please join me in reciting the Scout Oath. Scout sign. On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to God and my country and to obey the Scout law to help other people at all times to keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight. Please join me in reciting the Scout law. A Scout is trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent. Two. Please remain standing for an invocation by Mr. Mark Lambert.
A Scout is reverent. O gracious God and Father, we thank you for this special day in the life of Alexander Abraham. Today we celebrate the accumulated efforts Alexander has made over the years in advance of scouting. We think of all the merit badges he had learned along the way, the skills he learned, the character he developed, his service to our community and fellow scouts. Little by little, month by month, and year by year, he was faithful. And today we celebrate this achievement of trustworthy determination and hard work. So we ask you, our Lord, to bless Alexander. Bless his family who have supported and encouraged him. We ask your blessings to fall upon the scouting companions whose fellowship he has enjoyed along his adventures. We thank you for the scout leaders who gave and continue to give so much of their time and energy to develop young men like Alexander. Bless them with the certainty that their work has influenced the course of many lives. We all benefit because of their sacrifices and leadership. And we pray you bless this celebration as we rejoice with Alexander. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. At this time, I'd like to welcome Ms. Barb McGann, Committee Chair for Troop 309.
Please be seated. Ooh, I'm short. We are here today, of course, to celebrate a great success. Now it is my honor to tell you how to turn that success into more successes throughout the rest of your life. So how can you be successful? What is the secret? It's simple. And you learn this through scouting, be a failure. That may seem like a strange advice, but when you think about it, you've been failing ever since you became a scout. Do you remember the first time you tried to build a fire? You failed, didn't you? And what about the first hike, the one that ended in sore muscles and blisters? You didn't win the first time you ran for patrol leader. And when you did win, you made plenty of mistakes. When you tried to lead that patrol, you're not the only one who has failed. Thomas Edison discovered 1,800 ways not to make a light bulb before he invented the one that worked. Babe Ruth struck out 1,330 times on his way to hitting a record-setting 417 home runs. And Abraham Lincoln lost two elections for the House of Representatives and lost two elections for the Senate before becoming president. But these men never gave up. They never let their failures get them down. Instead, they learned from their mistakes, improved themselves, and went on to enjoy great success. So don't be afraid to make mistakes, and don't be afraid to fail. Remember, if you tried to do something and failed, you're vastly better off than if you tried to do something and succeeded, and succeeded. Congratulations, Alexander. It's been a pleasure working with you over these past years, and it's an honor to be up here. Thank you. I'd like to invite Mr. Mark Lambert back to the podium for the candle lighting ceremony.
Thank you, Ms. McGann. The Eagle Scout badge is the highest youth award which may be earned by a member of the Boy Scouting program. It represents another step forward, Scout, towards BSA's goal of developing citizenship, imparting character development, and enhancing personal fitness. To earn this highest rank in scouting, a scout must spend a great deal of time and effort. Therefore, the occasion that recognizes accomplishments should be memorable. Today, we shall follow the light of the Eagle Trail as we recognize the accomplishments of Alexander. I would like to call up Matthew Loftus to perform the lighting ceremony. When a boy becomes a scout, there is instilled within him, we call the scout, the spirit of scouting. This single lighted candle before you represents that spirit. Because the spirit of scouting embodies the principles of scout oath and law, it is a shining beacon of inspiration. Alone, this light may seem feeble, but when multiplied by more than 3 million boys in scouting around the world, it becomes very, very powerful indeed. After a boy enters scouting, the scout law that promises to obey begins with to guide his life. One by one, using the flame from the spirit of scouting, we shall light candles symbolizing the 12 points of the scout law. As a candle is lit for each part of the scout law, let us pay careful attention to the words and rededicate ourselves to the principles contained within these words, which are important building blocks in the foundation of a strong character. A scout is trustworthy. A scout tells the truth. He keeps his promise, honesty, a part of his code of conduct. People can always depend on him. A scout is loyal. A scout is true to his family, friends, scout leaders, school, nation, and world community. A scout is helpful. A scout is concerned about other people. He willingly volunteers to help others without expecting a payment or reward. A scout is friendly. A scout is a friend to all. He is a brother to other scouts. He seeks to understand others. He represents those with customs and ideas that are different from his own. A scout is courteous. A scout is polite to everyone regardless of age or position. He knows that good manners make it easier for people to get along. A scout is kind. A scout understands that there is strength in being gentle. He treats others as he would want to be treated. He does not harm or kill anything without a good reason. A scout is obedient. A scout follows the rules of his family, school, and troop. He obeys the laws of his community and country. If he thinks these rules and laws are unfair, he tries to have them changed in an orderly manner rather than disobey them. A scout is cheerful. A scout looks on the bright side of life. He cheerfully does tasks that come his way. He tries to make others happy. A scout is thrifty. A scout works to pay his way and help others. He saves for the future. He protects and conserves the natural resources. He carefully uses time and property. A scout is brave. A scout can face danger even if he is afraid. He has the courage to stand for what he thinks and is right, even if it laughs at him and threaten him. A scout is clean. A scout keeps his body and his mind fit clean. He goes around with those who believe in living the same ideas. He keeps his home and community clean. A scout is reverent. A scout is reverent towards God. He is faithful in his religious duties, and he respects the beliefs of others. The other part of the spirit of scouting is a scout oath. It contains three promises or duties that every scout must accept. Matthew will light the candle of each part of the oath as I recite it. On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to guide my country. If the scouts could please stand as we recite this again, scout sign. On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to guide my country, to obey the scout law, and to help others at all times, and to keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight. Two, you may be seated. As you can see, when each part of the oath and law is in place, the spirit of scouting burns very brightly. At this time, I would like to invite Mr. Larry Ney, Scoutmaster Troop 309, to the podium for the presentation of the Eagle Award.
Thank you, Mark. I think, Matthew, you can take a seat, if you will. Before I begin, I just want to tell you, Alexander, how proud and honored I am to be here today to present this award to you. One of the most proudest moments, I think, in a tenure of a Scoutmaster is to be a part of an Eagle Court of Honor. So congratulations and well done. Before I begin, let's say, Honor Guard, will you please escort the parents of Alexander, that would be Mark and Lynn, to the stage, please. And will Eagle candidate Alexander Abraham report front and center for the presentation. Ladies and gentlemen of the court, I represent all scouts who have received the Eagle Scout badge. And with saying so, I'd like to recognize all the Eagle Scouts in the room. So if you are an Eagle Scout amongst us and I can feel your energy, please stand up and be recognized. A round of applause, please. Thank you, Eagle Scouts. You may be seated. We concur with the Board of Review's recommendations that Alexander received the Eagle Scout Award, and as the with the powers to be with the National Council that have granted such award, we are here today to present that. The candidate has passed all the requirements for this award. We do believe that he should understand that the Eagle rank has responsibility as well as one of honor. It is my duty to inform you of those responsibilities. There are several sections of the Eagle Award that I'll go through. The white section of the Eagle badge represents honor. The first responsibility of an Eagle Scout is to live with honor. An Eagle's honor is sacred. Honor is the foundation of all character. Character is what one really is, not what one really thinks. He is. An Eagle Scout will live so that he reflects upon his family, church, school, friends in a positive manner. May the white of your badge remind you to live with honor always. The second obligation of an Eagle Scout is loyalty. It is the designation by the blue in the badge. Without loyalty, all character lacks direction. Neither pain nor profit, pride nor personal loss shall change him in his loyalty. Let the blue on your badge remind you of to be loyal. The third obligation of an Eagle Scout is courage, symbolized by the red in the badge. Courage gives character force and strength. Trusting in God and with faith in his fellow man, he faces each day unafraid and seeks his share of the world's work to do. Let the red on your badge remind you always to be courageous. The fourth obligation of the Eagle Scout is service. He extends a helping hand to those who toil along the scouting trail, just as others helped him in his achievement to the Eagle rank. The habit of a good turn must take on a new meaning through life of service for those in need. He protects and defends the weak and helpless. He aids and comforts the unfortunate and oppressed. He upholds the rights of others while defending his own. He knows well and will always be prepared to put forth his best. Remember, real leadership is founded upon real service. At this time, it is my distinct honor and pleasure and privilege to present Alexander with his Eagle Scout Award. We're going to start with the neckerchief and then the pin. Thank you, Mark and Lynn. Yeah, round of applause. Will the escorts please escort Mark and Lynn back to their seats, please? Thank you. So if that wasn't enough, let's talk about some of the next steps in Alexander's progress. It's now time to acknowledge the efforts of Alexander beyond the rank of Eagle through the presentation of an Eagle Palm. In addition to earning 21 required merit badges for the rank of Eagle, Alexander also earned 5 additional merit badges. By earning a total of 26 merit badges, he has earned 1 Eagle Palm. On behalf of the Boy Scouts of America, the Central Florida Council, Riverside District, and Troop 309, I am pleased to present the Bronze Eagle Palm to Alexander. Of course, there's a charge involved, not financial, but let's say an expression of words. The Boy Scouts of the world constitute one of the most wholesome and significant movements in history. You may have been counted worthy of its highest rank in its membership. All who know you rejoice in your achievement. Your position, as you well know, is one of honor and responsibility. You are a marked man. As an Eagle Scout, you have assumed a solemn obligation to do your duty to God, to country, and to your fellow Scouts, and to mankind. This is a great undertaking. As you live up to your obligations, you bring honor to yourself and your fellow scouts. If you fail, you bring down the good name of all true and worthy scouts. It's kind of a lofty thing there. Your responsibility goes beyond your fellow scouts, though, to your God and country. America has many good things to give you and your children after you, but these good things depend on the qualities instilled in your people, in her people. You are prepared to help America in all that she needs most. She has a great past, and you are here to make her future greater. I charge you to undertake your duty with solemn dedication. Be a leader, but lead only toward the best. Lift up every task you do and every office you hold with high level of service to God and your fellow man to finest living. We have too many who use their strength and their intellect to exploit others for selfish gain. I charge you to be among those who dedicate your skills and ability to the common good. Build America upon the solid foundation of clean living, honest work, unselfish service to your community, and reverence for God. Whatever others may do, you will leave behind you a record of which every scout may be proud. And with that, I'd yield to Eagle Scout Alexander Abraham.
Hello, everyone. We're going to take a minute or two for a quick intermission, and then we'll be back. If you need to use the restroom or get water, do so now. I was writing this portion of the script at 1:30 a.m. today, and I thought to myself, Mom was right. I should have finished writing the script sooner. With that said, I'd like to ask for my mom, Lynn Steffen, my dad, Mark Abraham, and my grandma, Gaithiel Steffen, to join me up here. Through the years, we've had our highs and lows. We've had joyous and mournful occasions. I have lived in the same house my whole life, and thankfully, I've had the same parents my whole life. To some of you, 18 years may seem like a long time. Looking back, our time together has been short, but to me, that makes it all the more meaningful. Dad, through the years, you helped me to excel as an individual, helping to prepare me for a world of chaos. When I needed advice or guidance, I went to you. Many times I didn't like your advice, but every time it was necessary for me to hear you out so I could understand my own ignorance. Mom, throughout the years, you taught me to respect others, treat others as I'd like to be treated, and encouraged me to continue in scouting. When I was in seventh grade, I was assigned to a huge project in English class. I told you I had no idea how I'd get it done. You said, "How do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time." I listened to you, but as the hours ticked by, Allison, my sister, and I split the work. She did half, I did half. Then we used the printer to photocopy each other's work. A little dumb. Yes, we were very tired. Thank you, Dad, for taking our side when the teacher contacted you. The next time I had a big assignment, I took your advice. I learned from my mistakes and learned that listening to your mom is wise. You both helped me reason with the world. Those that know me well know that I always have a reason for almost everything I say or do. you, Mom and Dad, helped me to understand morality, humility, and the necessity of a pursuit of knowledge. Mom, to thank you for helping over the years, I'd like to present you with the Eagle Mother Pin. Dad, thank you for helping me over the years. I'd like to present you with the Eagle Father Pin. Grandma, for part of my life, you lived in Indiana, but every summer since I was a baby, I visited you for 2 weeks. You'd buy Allison and I special cereal with special cereal bowls that had built-in straws. You had a collection of cool trinkets all over the house that we'd spend hours playing with. You got us bikes, even though we were only there for 2 weeks, and it made those 2 weeks even more awesome. When we visited Grandma's house, it was a home away from home. We visited one time in winter. We built mini snowmen, carved a bunk bed in the ice, and laid in it until we were soaking wet, and we made little snowballs. At the end of it all, we were wet and cold. You dried us off, warmed us up, and made us feel loved, as you always do. After you moved to Florida, we only got closer. You taught us different card games, joined us for family dinners, and spent the day with us on every holiday. My life would not be the same without you. I am thankful for all the time we've spent together and for the person you've helped me become. Grandma, to thank you for helping me over the years, I'd like to present you with the Eagle Grandmother Pin. Honor Guard, may you escort them back to their seats. One more pin to present. I was first asked who my Eagle mentor was when I was completing the paperwork for my Eagle project. I said, I don't have one. I've had so many individuals in my life that have helped me throughout the years, so many that have guided me, offered support, and made it possible for me to stand here today at this Court of Honor. I'd like to ask Mrs. Barbara McGann to join me up here. Mrs. McGann is the committee chair for Troop 309. It is her job, as such, to approve or deny paperwork for Eagle projects and take part in board of reviews. Yet she did much more. When I initially met with her with my Eagle project proposal, she dedicated 2 hours out of her day to make sure I fully understood every aspect of the proposal and the Eagle process. When I met with her about my Eagle Scout application after the project was complete, she dedicated even more time out of her day to help me. She didn't just do her voluntary job as the committee chair for Troop 309. She followed the tenets of the Scout Oath and Law and went above and beyond to make sure I was fully equipped to become an Eagle Scout. I am truly impressed by your commitment to the success of Scouts in this troop and your faithfulness to the tenets of Scouting. Mrs. McGann, to thank you for your help, I'd like to present you with the Eagle Mentor Pin. I'd like to recognize a few notable individuals that have guided me in my scouting career. First, I'd like to ask Mr. Lambert to stand to be recognized. As I began my Eagle journey, Mr. Lambert was kind and helpful. He'd courteously ask me at meetings how I was doing with my rank progress, and he was personable, always genuinely asking me about school or sports. When I asked him last minute if I could meet with him to have requirements for a merit badge reviewed and signed off before my 18th birthday, he graciously said yes and helped me. As I was planning for this court of honor and writing the scripts, Mr. Lambert set an example script for me to reference and utilize for the betterment of my court of honor. Mr. Lambert, I appreciate all you've done for me over the years and all your help to make this day possible. If I had another pin, I'd give it to you.
Thank you. Honor to you.
Next, I'd like to ask Mrs. Jan Lambert to stand to be recognized, if she is here. She's not here, I'll still read it. Mrs. Lambert, you have always been kind and helpful to my family. You helped my mom with all aspects of this ceremony today. Without you, this court of honor would not be near as great as it is. Thank you so much for all your help. Mr. Larry Nace and Mr. John Kelly, please stand to be recognized. I served as senior patrol leader and assistant senior patrol leader under both of you. I had a lot of fun doing it, too. You both guided me. You both helped me to learn from my mistakes and encouraged me to be a better version of myself. I will never forget the memories I made under your leadership. I am all the better from them. Thank you both. Lastly, I'd like to thank Marsha Brush. I know she's not here. When I was in elementary school, you visited my classroom to tell us about a wonderful program called Cub Scouts. A bit later, I decided to join Scouts with my friend Eddie. We both joined PAC 380 in Indian Harbor Beach. Without her involvement in the school system, there is a chance I wouldn't have had the opportunity to become a Scout and be honored here today as an Eagle. I thank her for the contributions she has made to the scouting world and the impact she has had on my life. I could go on, but for all our sakes, I won't. To all those who have helped me along the way, thank you. I have one last portion for you, and it is the longest. I'd like to present you with a short speech that I wrote for this court of honor. I felt it necessary and proper to share my thoughts on the significance of scouting with all of you. I hope you find it informative and see scouting as I do. The American pursuit of freedom was immortalized on July 4th, 1776. The most notable founders believed in a nation driven by the free man, a nation of individualism free of governmental tyranny. Prudent founders instilled safeguards. The instructions of the Declaration of Independence in 1776, the U.S. Constitution in 1788, and the Bill of Rights in 1791. Why did they think the great nation of the United States could stoop to such a level of oppression? Such is the way of history. The scouting movement started in 1907 by Robert Baden Powell in the UK and spread to the United States of America in 1910. Scouting focused on building individuals with pillars of discipline. Through these teachings, it was intended that boys would develop qualities necessary for serving the community, their families, friends, and neighbors. With the teachings of scouting spread across the world, the local level of every community with scouts had a helping hand that kept people safe and full of communitarian joy. Those who are in scouting or who have been in scouting know that this movement improves the lives of those directly involved and the recipients of the scout service. As scouts, we learn to be driven and hardworking. Everything must be earned: merit badges, ranks, food, and respect. Living in modern-day America, it is safe to say that the teachings of the scouts are as prevalent as they were during the First World War, which began only 4 years after scouting started in America. As scouts, we have a unique opportunity. If we so choose, we have the ability to direct the future of our country and the world. One scout can touch the lives of his neighbors. A few scouts can touch the lives of their community. And many scouts can touch the lives of every living person in the world. Thus, the scouting movement has the power to change the world and brighten the future. A scout learns to be independent, but also to trust his fellow scouts. A scout learns to help others, but also to be responsible for one's own needs. A scout puts others before himself, but also knows that it is necessary to find a balance between the needs of the community and the needs of oneself. One man can't care for the needs of an entire state, just as one government can't care for the needs of a whole country. For these reasons, the strength of the local population is the most important factor in the well-being of a country. The further dependence strays from the community, the less individualization is considered. Thus, it is only fitting that as scouts, we take it upon ourselves to selflessly instill our values into the community. If not us, then whom? Scouting to the community is like glue. Not school glue, sticky, sticky glue. As scouts, we have a duty to our community, not only as a whole, but to each and every individual therein. Everyone needs someone. As a scout utilizing the principles of the oath and law, you, future Eagles, must remember to care for yourselves, your friends, your family, and your neighbors. If not you, then whom? All those years you helped with scouting for food, volunteered to help at an Eagle project, picked up trash on the beach, and so much more, you were helping your community. Without your service, a child could have gone hungry. Sea life could have been endangered from pollution, and you wouldn't feel as accomplished and humbled as you do now. As an Eagle at the end of my scouting journey, I pass on this wisdom with the hopes that you will be more knowledgeable, experienced, and prepared to take on the world than I am. I pass on this wisdom knowing that you will struggle and fail at times, with the hope that you will learn from your mistakes as I did. I pass on this wisdom so that you may strengthen yourselves as individuals in scouting, so that you may continue to care for our community as part of a legacy other scouts started long before we were born. Thank you. I'd like to ask Mr. Nace to come to the podium.
With every good meeting, we start our closing ceremonies with Scoutmaster Minute. I have a Scoutmaster Moment. We'll make it too long, but I thought it'd be appropriate to talk about what I've learned today as being a part of this Court of Honor. A Scoutmaster learns something new at every Court of Honor, especially at an Eagle Court of Honor. So what have I learned today? I learned that being a leader is not enough to attain the rank of Eagle. Don't get me wrong, learning to be a leader is very important and is vital for a scout to become an Eagle, but it's just not enough. A scout must also be a successful follower. Surprised? Eagle scouts just don't appear out of the sky. A scout must want to obtain the rank, usually from an early age. I've observed that many Eagle candidates said that their first serious thought of becoming an Eagle was at a ceremony just like the one today, at an Eagle Court of Honor, that they attended often as a junior scout. or tenderfoot or second class. And from that point forward, they had that dream to strive for Eagle. The successful ones followed that dream and moved along that Eagle trail. Throughout their scouting career, a scout is often tested. In those situations, he or she has to follow their heart to keep up their spirit, stamina, and mental toughness. I know that Alexander faced many, many challenges along that Eagle Trail. We saw some of that on the video. But he didn't lose his spirit. He followed his heart, and he moved along that trail. Often when we are younger, and as we are older too, a scout has to decide which path to take. Sometimes the decision is clear. There's a right way, and maybe not so right of a way. Sometimes the decision only becomes clear after you look back, and sometimes the choice is never clear, and even months or years later, you're not sure that you made the right decision or you took the right path. In many situations, the Eagle candidate must follow his or her gut. Call it intuition, experience, or even a guess, the Eagle knows that he or she needs to make a decision and a choice. And using all of your resources, including your gut level sense of right and wrong, you, Alexander, followed that sense and you moved along that trail. And of course, Eagle candidates follow the advice of parents mostly. Scoutmasters, Eagle advisors, committee chairs, charter organization reps, fellow leaders and fellow scouts, teachers, friends, strangers, and maybe even astrologers, I don't know. There's a lot. It takes a village to make an Eagle. Some of the advice is good, some of the advice is better. The successful Eagle Scout learns which advice to discard, which ones to follow, and move along that trail. What I learned today, maybe what I relearned today, was that Eagle Scouts are good at following as they are at leading. And maybe, just maybe, that made the difference. Maybe that's the reason Alexander's standing before us here today as an Eagle Scout. Thank you.
At this time, I would like to call Senior Patrol Leader Mason Terry to come forward to lead the retirement of the colors.
Audience, please rise. Scout, attention. Color Guard, advance. Color Guard, retrieve the colors. Scout salute. Color Guard, reform. Color Guard, dismissed. Two. Back to Alexander.
Here's your script. At this time, before we depart, please receive this benediction. Heavenly Father, we have heard today a lot about character, persistence, courage, loyalty, cheerfulness, service, setting an example, protecting the weak and the helpless. Lord, we admire these qualities, and we pray that you will serve Alexander well over his lifetime. We know that being an Eagle Scout is a lifelong responsibility, and we pray not only Alexander continues to exemplify these qualities, but we ask that he might influence others to do the same. Now let us go with your blessing to do a good turn daily. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you all. This formally ends the ceremony, and I'd like to invite everybody on behalf of Alexander Abraham to Fellowship Hall for some lunch. Thank you all for attending.